from the desert down in Carthway, wind in my silver hair, smell the shade of the evening rising up through the air. Up ahead in the distance, I see the palace of dust. See how it drinks in the morning sun, but now enter I must. So I stood in the doorway, listened to Pyatt pretend. I remember thinking to myself, this could mean wisdom or this could mean hell. You must only take the right door, go up the stairways. There were noises in the corridor, I thought I heard him say, hey, welcome to the house of the Undying. Such a mazy place, such a crazy place. Plenty of rooms in the house of the Undying. And when your mind is clear, there are visions here. Dwarfs raping a maiden, chewing her breasts. A dead king with a wolf's head, and savagely slaughtered guests. Lemon tree in a courtyard, a door painted red. I want a hug from my sweet old bear, but I remember he's dead. A silver prince with a baby looks at me with indigo eyes. He said, his is a song of ice and fire. The dragon has three heads. And all these visions and horrors and wonders I see. Days gone by, days yet to come, and days that will never be. Welcome to the house of the Undying. Such a mazy place, such a crazy place. Myriad rooms in the house of the Undying. And if you have no fear, there is wisdom here. A floating heart near the ceiling, cups of fire and ice. Blue shades round a table, whisper words of advice. I feel a lick on my eyeball, I realize I'm the feast. Drogon rips at the rotting heart, fire roars from the beast. Last thing I remember, I was running for the door. I had to find the passage back to the place I was before. In the Undying Chamber, there is wisdom to receive. You can have it any time you like, but you can never leave. She could hear the shrieks of the Undying as they burned, their high, thin, papery voices crying out in tongues long dead. Their flesh was crumbling parchment, their bones dry wood soaked in tallow. They danced as the flames consumed them. They staggered and writhed and spun and raised blazing hands on high, their fingers bright as torches. Danny pushed herself to her feet and bulled through them. They were light as air, no more than husks, and they fell at a touch. The whole room was ablaze by the time she reached the door. Drogon, she called, and he flew to her through the fire. Outside a long dim passageway stretched serpentine before her, lit by the flickering orange glare from behind. Danny ran, searching for a door to her right, a door to her left, any door, but there was nothing, only twisty stone walls and a floor that seemed to move slowly under her feet, writhing as if to trip her. She kept her feet and ran faster, and suddenly the door was there ahead of her, a door like an open mouth. When she spilled out into the sun, the bright light made her stumble. Pyatt Pree was gibbering in some unknown tongue and hopping from one foot to the other. When Danny looked behind her, she saw thin tendrils of smoke forcing their way through the cracks in the ancient stone walls of the Palace of Dust. and rising from between the black tiles of the roof.